Alola trainers, my name is Alessandro, aka I Caterpie from Po Town Store, and I'm here today to show you my Raichu deck and list. Let's dive into it! Okay, trainers, here we are with the Raichu deck. I want to say something first. English is not my main language and I'm from Italy, I'm Italian. So if during the video, and it will happen, if during the video I say something wrong, the wrong term, the wrong verb, please, I'm so sorry about that and try to forgive me, but this is one of my first video that I make in English and I want to make it for Po Town Store because this is an incredible opportunity for this wonderful channel and I want to do my best to grow it up and I want to do it in English so most of you can look and maybe appreciate the decklist that I propose. So sorry and thanks for watching. I'm here today to talk to you about the Raichu deck. When I talk about Raichu, I'm not talking about a Pikachrome deck. I'm talking actually about a Raichu and a Alolan Raichu. Why? Because both of them make an interesting combo. With the Raichu, you can use Never Give Up. You can use this attack only and only, so remember that because it's very important, if you have at least 3 more prizes than your opponent. So you have to sacrifice, you have to give up, you have to concede 3 prizes to your opponent. At least 3 prizes. You can give 4, but it will be definitely better if you give just 3 prizes. At some point, your opponent has 3 prizes left, you have 6, so you can use Never Give Up and attack all the lightning energy from your discard pile to your Pokémon in any way you like. So, actually, we want to just attack the energy to one Pokémon, only one, and this Pokémon is the Alolan Raichu. Why? Because the Alolan Raichu has this attack, Electro Rain. We can discard all the lightning energy attacked to him and make 30 damage to one of your opponent's Pokémon for each energy. So, if we have something like 20 energy, we make 600 damage and we can decide how to make it. So, maybe our opponent has a Dedenne in play, Dedenne has 160, so if they have 2 Dedenne is 320, if they have 3 Dedenne is 580, so with just one attack we can make 6 prizes in one turn. And it's possible. I already make it and I know for sure it's possible and that's why I want to propose this deck today to you because I'm having so much fun play it and I want to share this with you. In order to make all of this real, in order to make all of this happen, I create a deck around these 2 cards. So these 2 cards are my main attacker, my main support. My strategy is making by these 2 Pokémon. But they can't just work by themselves. They need someone else. And this someone else is Talonflame. With the first attack, Fast Flight, we can discard our hands and draw 6. Why is this good? I don't know if you ever noticed yet, but we have 26 lightning energy in the deck. So basically, we just want to discard everything we have all the time, more than once during our turn, and trying to discard all our energy in the discard pile as soon as possible. In the same time, we want that our opponent took some prize. So, hey, this is a Talonflame, please take it! That's the main strategy, basically. Also, we have 4 Dedenne. Why? Because Dedenne is an amazing card. Actually, you can find 2 copies of this Dedenne in the Trainer Toolkit. It's already on the Po Town Store website, so go check on that because it's so easy to find this Dedenne and it's the most powerful card that we actually use in this period, so go check on that. Then, when we play this card in our bench, we can discard our hand and draw other 6 different cards. So, in this moment, oh, guys, just wanted and perturbed. It's very important. It's very important. Don't make this mistake. I saw in the lab that a lot of people sometimes make this mistake, and don't do that. Only wanted and perturbed. But with the Talonflame, we can actually see a lot of cards. Basically, because we don't play any supporter besides Apu, and it's not so common that we saw Apu in our first tower. So Talonflame and Dedenne are the cards that make all of this real. So Apu, look at the top 6 cards in the deck, then put 2 in your hand and discard the others. Perfect. Take 2, discard others. Take Raichu, discard energy. That's the point. Sometimes we want to prevent a card from being discarded. So Oranguru. 2 copy of Oranguru. Why Oranguru? Because with the Private Wisdom we can just save one card from being discarded and put it on top of the deck. You will see how powerful is this Oranguru. And there are 2 other important factors. After we use the energy buff attacks of Raichu, we are completely exposed. So if our opponent play a Boss Order and design Raichu to be our next Pokémon active, we can lose the game. So how we can prevent that? We can play Resist Stamp. I have 3 copies of Resist Stamp in the deck because after I play Raichu, I don't want that my opponent has Boss Order. And before I play Raichu, I'm sure that my opponent has at least 3 prize left. And not more, because otherwise I will never play level it up because I can. So let's just stand by 3 and just hope that our opponent doesn't get the boss order after that. Also, I play Mew, because Mew prevents all damage done to our Pokemon in the bench. So if our opponent plays something that can designate the Alolan Raichu as target of the attack, we can use Mew and prevent all the damage. So I'm making sure that that Alolan Raichu can survive. And even if not, we can recover it with the Ordinary Rod and try again with another Never Give Up. I play, of course, for Quick Ball. For Quick Ball, Quick Ball is just a basic card for every deck, so I don't need to explain that, but I need to explain the Telescopic Sight, because the Telescopic Sight allows us to make 30 more damage for the benched Pokémon V and VMAX and GX. The point is, if we make 30 damage to a V Pokémon, a Pokémon V in the bench, we can make plus 30. But if we designated 4 Pokémon, all of them are V and GX, we can actually make 120 more damage during one turn with just one tool card. So in this particular deck, this card is so amazing cool. So that's why I need it. And this is it, this is the strategy. A lot of energy, a lot of Pikachu, a lot of yellow card, and I call this deck Exodia, because when you play the Exodia cards from Yu-Gi-Oh! You can just show them to your opponent and win the game, and that's exactly what I want to do with this deck. Never give up and one attack to win the game. So let's see if we can actually win a game with this amazing stuff. Okay, here we are ready to see this Exodia strategy in action. What I had to say about this deck, of course it's not a very common successful strategy, but we can use it sometimes to have fun, to finish the deck in one turn, to finish the game in one turn. And Pikachu, Dedenne, not a bad start. I want to start with Pikachu, of course. I have a lot of energy ready to discard, and I'm looking for the Talonflame. I'm playing against the Mad Party. This matchup is kind of easy if our opponent has no Mew in the bench. If our opponent has Mew, the game basically is over. Maybe I can attack with Mew, trying to knock out his Mew, but let's see. Gonna take Talonflame, maybe. Yep, and then I don't attack the energy because I have a lot of energy and I want to discard them all. Pikachu, energy, Viridian. I know that with Viridian I'm gonna help my opponent, but I don't care. I don't care, I want to help myself first. So, Pikachu, retreat, Talonflame. Okay. This is actually a good start, a very good start. All the game will basically define just by one question. Does my opponent play Mew? If he played, the game is over. Game is basically over. If he doesn't, we can kinda easy win. Let's see. Of course, this deck has no matchup for ADP. We can play against ADP, but we can try our best against all the other different deck. We don't have a game against me against ADP because of the GX, of course, and because he play a lot of boss order, he can easily knock out the Talonflame and then on through the den for win the game in 3 rounds. So let's completely forget about ADP and focus on all the other deck, because this is the goal here, trying to have fun with this new and interesting deck. Okay, the Denny, 2 Sinistia in play. I'm expected to survive for maybe not a lot of turn, but some turn. Okay, Raichu, I don't want to waste a Raichu, so I'm gonna play it, evolve the Pikachu, then the Denny. Apu, of course, there's no way I'm gonna take some energy here. I don't like my hand, so I'm gonna discard it. Fast flight. I discard my hand and then draw a lot of energy. This is the goal, always draw a lot of energy. Okay, the first Poltergeist is here. I want that my opponent makes some knockout. I really want that. It's kind of bad that I already have 2 ordinary road and 1 stamp out. But I have other 2 red stamp in my deck, so let's just hope to draw that. Okay, here comes the second Poltergeist. T-break again. Woods Mayala, Alistair. No, not exactly the common Mad Party decklist, but Great Ball. I'm really scared about Mew. I think I'm gonna play my Mew. Wow. Yes. Fast flight again. I discard all the cards in my hand. That's the goal, actually. I want to discard them, all of them. I already have 16 lightning energy. That's not bad. I just miss one thing now, that my opponent started to take some prizes. I need that my opponent takes some prizes, because if my opponent can't take any prizes, I can't attack with my never give up, so please take some prizes. Please. That's bad. He has 80 damage. Crobat! He has 80 damage right now. 100 damage. Quick ball. Wow. You really want this knockout. I really want this. Three, four, five. Still. You turn. You still need one mad party. Great ball. Miss it. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Mad party for just 100 damage. I'm alive. I'm alive. Okay, Talonflame, you can go. And I can play Apu, but let's just check my deck first. I have another Raichu and one stamp. He used just one boss sword. Come on! In your Raichu, man! Come on! Just look at this Talonflame! Look at this! He's so cool! Just kill him! Okay, Tea Break, Twin Energy. Evolution for nothing. My opponent has just 8 cards left. Oh! Lol. Well, we can. Actually, this deck is kinda cool for this reason. We can win because we can take all the prizes, but we can also win because we take none. So, this is just the deck. It's so strong. I don't know. Energy here. I just pass. My opponent finishes deck. So I guess I won. Boss order. Okay. You can take it. Mate, you finished your deck for this. You can take it. So, GG, one for us. We don't have the time to complete the strategy, but we win anyway. So let's focus on another game where we can actually make our strategy works. So let's go check another one. Steve, hi mate. So, call the coin flip. You lost the coin flip. It's okay. I start. Actually, a good start. So, Pikachu, Oranguru. Let's see what against we're playing. Jirachi, Deden. Viridian. Talonflame. Okay, actually a pretty good start. I have no idea what against I'm playing, but this is a good start. Zamazenta, not good for me. I think this is an ADP with the ADP Battle League box that you can actually find in the Pottown Store website, and you can find there are two really decent deck that you can play and you can buy and play. This is What my opponent are showing you is one of them, is the ADP Zacian deck. You can also find the Pika Chrome deck. They are two amazing products just to buy and start, so let's think about that. Marni. Okay, can save the rod. Mew. Oranguru. Fast flight. Okay, let's see what my opponent will decide to do. I mean, if he retreats with Jirachi and attack with Zacian, I can promote Mew and make damage. So if he decides to kill my Mew, I can actually win the game. If he instead start with the ADP, that will be a problem for me. Switch and knockout. I can do that. They have a lot of card in my deck, but I don't need rod, but I can use it. Oh, I have two Pikachu prize. Save stamp. This is not a good end. This is not a good end. I still have all the Apu in my deck. Energy to Zamazenta. He can't attack this turn, so maybe, just maybe. Energy switch, wow, not so 4 cards, energy switch, switch, not bad. I can sacrifice an Oranguru. I don't want nothing of this. The den, yes. I I just hope that he can take this knockout so I can promote Raichu, put Pikachu in the bench, stamp by two, and hope that he don't draw a Bossod. Pikachu stamp, and then never give up. I just have this shot. My opponent remain with two prizes, so if he take a boss order in the game, he win the game because he can one shot the Rinnegan. But I have one energy remaining in my deck, so I can retreat my Raichu in case he decides to not take a knockout. But I should have enough energy to win the game. I should. 20. Please! Miss this Bossod, please. Okay, hope it's not a boss order, so it's fine, but it can still take the catcher or custom catch or great catch, I mean any catcher. Didn't have the knockout. I just made 130. So next I have to retreat next. Raichu. Telescopic sight. Energy. Retreat. Raichu. Electro Rain. I discard all of the energy attack to this Raichu and then make 30 damage for each of them to my opponents. So. So, this damage that I put with Mew, so tactic. Because right now this Zachan just need 6 plus the telescopic, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. These are 210 damage plus the 10 damage that I put with you. This is enough. This has 230, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3. These damage are enough in order to kill them. This is the Exodia game! This is the game where Raichu can actually one-shot all of the Pokémon that my opponent has in play. If my opponent has another Pokémon, maybe a GX or a V1, we can put all the damage instead of the Jirachi on that one, and then we will take 6 prizes in one turn. We take actually 5 because my opponent only has 3 Pokemon in his play, but enough to win with this Exodia strategy. Thanks for watching this video, trainer. If you're looking for some other competitive game, you can check my YouTube channel, iCaterpie. And for sure, you have to subscribe this Potown Store Challenge, because in this channel, some of the most amazing content creators will show you step by step all of the fun and interesting deck that you can find on this trading card game. See you soon in the next video. Adola!